question is, when writing Forever For Now, you felt the presence of your mother. Was there any other time you felt like writing a version or writing a song?
I think I always try to have it, you know what I mean? Like, I think, you know, I don't know if it's like completely like that day where I just felt very
connected.
Yeah, like, but I feel like it's more like I'm always like kind of inviting God into the room and the muse into the room. You know, I believe in that very much, and so as I'm always trying to evoke that and like conjure that up and just kind of ask for it. That kind of creative openness to be in the room, you know, which I consider, like, you know, God.
Yeah, okay, I understand. Thank you. You are a brilliant songwriter. I also think of Swiss Light. It's cast into the car. It's crazy. But I also love how you connect the lyrics in your heart. It's just a bunch of different
I feel like that song was supposed to be about like kind of the ups and downs of my life in general, you know, where I just like, you know, I get really up and then I get down. I mean, basically, I get up, get down, you know. I just feel very like, you know, there were so many times that I thought I was like finally on the verge of something, and then I wasn't,
yeah,
you know. And I think that everybody has that experience, you know. And sometimes I try not to, you know, think so much about. You know, I had a lot of people talk about the meaning of the video. You know?
Yeah.
And, you know, first of all, a song called "When We're High" is not going to be like some lofty, crazy, kind of deep, meaningful song, really. But in a way, it was, because I feel like what I was like. Feeling was that, you know, I showed myself in the beginning with Lauren, and I'm just like kind of, you know, in a good place with her, and just, you know, kind of having really, you know, a deep relationship with someone. And then I think the rest, like the party part of the video, is more like about, you know, where I've been and where I could be, you know.
Okay.
Yeah, kind of like the kind of, you know, I live in Hollywood.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I can go out any night of the week and have a night like that. I've had many nights like that. I mean, not exactly looking like that, but, you know, just my friends and, like, you know, that I don't necessarily, you know, I'm not trying to not represent, like, you know, lesbian women or whatever. And I don't, a lot of those women are lesbians. But, you know, I feel like it was just like, you know, it's just like a night of the week that you venture out, and it was more of like fantasy, you know, kind of like, and fantasy of like, not even necessarily a good fantasy, just like the kind of like, everybody, you know, everybody's hanging out, like, and what does it amount to, you know what I mean? And I feel like the verses are more about, you know, really thinking about your life, and at the end of the day, what you want to look back on, you know? I don't know that anybody, I guess we look back on like the parties in our life and everything, you know, and how fun we were and stuff. But I think we also, you know, we can appreciate, because we've been through times like that, when we have like depth and meaningful relationships as well. So, but I think I've learned to respect the pendulum. You know, I think one of the most scary and exciting things about life is that it goes back and forth, you know, it's like, you know, and you just like kind of sometimes you're, you know, up, sometimes you're down, I mean, you know, it's like a Frank Sinatra song, and everybody goes through it, so, you know, we're just going through it together, and I'm just like, you know, I don't know, you know, I don't ever think to myself, I'm going to be happy forever now, you know, and I'm already like, you know, I mean, this year has been fantastic, but I've had lows, you know.
It must have been also hard, yes, for you, because it's very demanding.
Yeah, and you know, and you want to get. I also try to stay away from that. You know, I have people sometimes that'll ask me, and they'll be like, you know, but they're almost like kind of going, so are you worried? that this might be it. Like, you know, just that, you know, maybe it's just that song, whatever, to which I say, who fucking cares? You know? It's like, I've been lucky enough to experience this beautiful experience. Yes. You know, I could take it with me. I thought, when things started, I thought I was going to have a hit in Greece, and that was it.
Yeah.
And I was happy. I was like, fuck yeah. You know, I had people, I had, like, you know, like, colleagues and stuff, you know, like, acquaintances that I know through songwriting, they were like, I see how Boston would be a hit in Greece. And
yeah,
I was like,
yeah.
And I like kind of like didn't talk to them for a while because I was like so dismissive, you know?
Yeah,
like,
yeah,
it's
yeah.
like, and if it was, you know, a hit in Greece, like, that's it. I would be thankful as fuck for that. You know? What a lucky, beautiful thing. And then, you know, it spread a bit.
Yes.
And,
a little bit.
Yeah, and I'm just like, you know, my biggest thing now is like, I don't know how to fit any more gratitude into my body, you know what I mean?
No,
it's
I know. I know. But you are doing everything you can, really,
yeah.
And it shows, during your shows, you can really see it. Like today, it was amazing. The connection you made with
that. Thanks. I want to like run out, I want to like
I know.
Run over people's like heads to the like back and be like, ah! I don't know what to do.
I know. We would love to give everyone the chance like we are having, but I know it's impossible. My next question, sorry. We are all fans of your song, It's All Good. We only sang it in Romania,
I think. You know, I'm like, so you think I should put that on the next record?
Yes.
Okay. You know, it's funny, I wrote that song actually with the woman that I wrote Someday with, the woman from Florence and And that was also a song that I wrote in that time period. I remember I was in England and I was really, I was bummed out because I forget me and my ex were like, we were going down. I just could feel it, I knew it. And we were in London.
A good time,
yeah. Yeah, and we were gonna go, I hope I'm not mixing up the times, but we were gonna go to this wedding. We were all gonna go to this wedding that was our very good friend's wedding. And I remember I had written also a song that we called Dreamcatcher. Which I'd love to put that on. It's like, yeah, I have a really vivid memory of being in this, being in Suffolk, England, at this wedding. It was at this beautiful cottage, like a church in the middle of the countryside in Suffolk, England. And I was listening back to some of the stuff I had done that week, including like this Dreamcatcher song. And I remember I was sitting alone in the room and I said, the song is very sad, but like I knew it was coming from like the pit of despair. It's like very, very sad. And she came in the room and I was like kind of crying. I was like, and it was weird because she just knew that she knew what I was upset about, you know, because we were together, but shit was fucked up. And I just remember It's All Good was in that period, and it was like, I have a whole bunch of songs that I write where I try to make myself feel better. It's like the get me out of sad situation. Where I'm like, that's why like a lot of my songs are like trying to like kind of be like, it's okay, don't worry about it. Because I'm always trying to say that to myself.
Okay. Yeah. We really like it and we're hopeful that we
I think it's also I didn't do it because I was having trouble getting it to sound right with the band. I'll work on it if you guys think it's good.
Yes, I think it has enormous potential.
Yeah. February to like April, and I remember remember I was like, oh shit, I'm onto something. I knew something was happening for me. And by the end of the year, by end of September, I had a deal with Warner Brothers, and I had a big commercial, a symphony commercial, whatever, Into the Wild, and I was kind of off again into my artist career, which was interesting because I bought the ukulele in September of 2009. I was very taken with it. I always wanted one, but it was one of those things. The ukulele to me symbolizes coming back to the reason why you do something.
Yeah.
You know, because it's fun. You know, and I had spent like all this, like, you know, it was 2009. I've been doing this already, for a while, and I was like, it was my job now. I signed a publishing deal, or it was my job to go into a room with people I don't know and try to write a song for someone.
Yeah.
And try to get someone to sing my songs if I wasn't going to sing them myself. And it's a pretty daunting task. I mean, there's a lot of songs out there. There's a lot of people writing a lot of songs. And there's only so many great artists, or so many artists even, And I have a lot of songs with artists that are like, not that known, or haven't broken yet, or didn't make it, or whatever, And then I have songs, obviously, with people who have, but it's like a very, it's not an easy thing. So the ukulele, I only did it for myself.
It's the best thing you
could. Yeah, and it, I've said this many times in an interview, it kind of opened the door in my heart, pure joy and love of making up stuff, making things, Whereas I kind of felt like with guitar, it wasn't as off the cuff, The ukulele, I just sat around a bed and played, And I've said also that it started my whistling, because I would just sit. I didn't even really sing when I played the uke. I would just kind of whistle stuff, and that's all that. So when I was writing Into the Wild, I was whistling that unconsciously. I was just sitting alone whistling, and then I became that whistle button, So it was that year I just really suddenly everything just went back. I don't know what you guys have experienced as far as things you love that have become part of your work. Cause even I don't know if anybody, you guys play sports or anything. When you go from being like a kid playing, I played soccer. But then I remember when sports changed to running so I could stay in shape, And it was just I used to love to run, but now it's I have to run so I can stay in shape so I can feel good about it, And it's just you start to hate running more than love it, It's it's very much like that with music. You get sick of it because, you have to do it. The youth was just fun. I mean, to be so wordy, I feel like we're just having a conversation.
I also wanted to ask about the French Repeated song.
I don't remember this song. What is that song?
French Repeated.
Every time I I would always like give my girlfriend my computer, like whatever girlfriend I had, and it was like somewhere in the shifting of giving it away and backing shit up, I lost, like, I can't remember where a lot of things are, but people have them. I just don't know, like, I forget.
Okay, I understand.
I know, I think I have a vague idea of this song.
Okay, sorry, I mean, I'm too nervous, but Stupid Song is also one of my favorites.
Oh, fuck, what is that song? I do like that song.
I will send you a okay. I love your original songs, but I also love the ability of singing main covers. We all witnessed in London a shampoo priest, and we were amazed by
it. Oh, really? Oh, God, I feel so bad. You know what I always do? I always learn a fucking cover that day, and then I'm like, let's do it on stage, yay! I wreck it. But thank you, yeah, I really love that song.
We are all crying with it. Oh, amazing.
That's a great song. Did you know that song already?
No, I first heard it when you sang it. You sang it three times when I started praying. And then I started, I shouted it this, and then I was just on the floor. It was amazing.
Yeah, it's a great song. It's really,
is it big for you? Is it meaning?
You know, I just, yeah, I mean, it's just, you know, there's so many things in my life that, like, I just, you know, like, someone was playing a song the other day, and sometimes just the melody of a song, I mean, I think that's like, you know, lost in it. It just,
yeah,
it started me like, you know, tearing up and crying, and it was just the way that this guy, like, said the words and sang the melody that just, like, I related to it. It, like, that's what I love about songs, is that it's not always about exact lyrical content. It's like the voice and the melody, and you know, because I think it's like almost like a song kind of hits you in a bunch of different places.
Yes.
You know, and like it's like some like other places that we don't know. You know what I mean? And like we're kind of like always amazed that, like, you know, and then we go back. Like I listen to that song that I'm talking about again, and I realize it wasn't quite what I thought it was about, but it was. There was like a part in it, I remember, and it was funny because I had just done this beautiful show in Lucca in Italy, and Lauren and I and the whole band were in the bus playing songs, and Lauren and my bass player loved this song, and I remember I was like in a really mellow mood. I was just tired, I was like really spent, and I was just like, I started crying, and you know, Lauren was like, we haven't even talked about it. I've never even talked to her about it. But it was like weird. I just don't know where songs kind of get you, and that's why I love writing songs so much, because I don't even know where they come from sometimes for myself, and then I don't know why certain songs and singers affect me. I think it's like has a lot to do with the mystery of life, or we don't know why we're attracted to people, we don't know why certain things make us angry or happy.
Okay, last question, because I don't want to tell you.
Do you want some more wine? Yeah, you do.
Okay, so final question.
It's the final question.
Yeah. Okay, you often collaborate with different artists.
Broken Vow. Oh,
yeah.
The Kooks.
Yeah.
Oh shit, I know, I'm excited about that.
And it was...
Is it out?
Yeah, it was out.
It just came out? When did it come out?
No, it's, I think, what's the month of it?
Oh, really?
It's April, I think. April,
oh, yeah.
May, it was May.
No.
Yeah,
really? It's been out that long?
Yeah.
Jesus Christ, I'm singing on it too, right?
Yes, and that's what my question, because sometimes you collaborate and you only write song, and sometimes you also put like a back of the and do you want to do a song with more rock?
Yeah, you know, I would, like, I think you can tell from, like, my shows
that
I'm, like, a rock singer in a way.
Yes.
You know, that's what's, like, kind of, like, I think what I like and what's confusing about me in a way that you can really see the, like, almost, like, blues rock singer in me, even though I'm, like, you know, like, kind of writing, pop songs, alternative songs. But yeah, I don't know, I'm gonna see where it takes me. I think like get away with doing like a rock song. Even like, you know, the end of No Witness is kind of like reminiscent of shit I used to do, you know? Like, I always like, I remember when we were rehearsing for the tour, you know, and I was like, oh shit, like, this is like the old stuff I used to do, and it's not easy. That's the stuff that kind of like is hard, you know, sometimes. But not, you know. Part of the difficult part about getting out there for me was that a lot of times I like so many different kinds of music and I have so many kind of angles to what, like, you know, people like, I think like sometimes label people would scratch their heads and be like, what genre, you know, like where do we, how do we market this? Yeah, and I, you know, I don't give a shit, you know what I mean? Like, that's why when I go in the studio and I write, I try to be as free as possible because I don't even like saying, oh, I'm writing a song for myself right now. I just like to go and feel, you know, just fucking go for it, you know. So I might just put out a whole rock record.
Well,
Or just keep doing rock elements in songs, you know. Instruments, like just like, you know, we spoke about the uke. I've been playing a lot of guitar lately. I got a new guitar that I've been playing. It's such a lovely instrument that, like, a lot of instruments, like, for me, have songs in them. Like, when I start, and the song and the instrument that I had, even It's All Good, you know, that came out of, I don't know if you remember, but the littler guitar I played before, with the sunburst on it. It had a special tuning, and I remember I wrote a bunch of songs with that guitar. It just like, it just clicked something that, like, it made me hear music different. That's what the uke did. It made me hear things different, and then I just, you know, wanted to like run like crazy in that direction for fun, you know? It's like, I'm like a dog if you hold up like a really cool time, like.
I understand.
Like, that's why Orson has thousands of toys at home. It's so funny. Like, I bring home everybody's toys that they give for him. It's amazing. And it's, I don't know, did you ever see that picture on Instagram where he's in a pile of toys? And I,
But he's not, like,
he is. Yeah, he's the best. And I can't wait to see him.
I'm sure. Well, thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
The best. My pleasure. Thank you for doing such a great job. You really, like, I mean, I've read your blog and it's so thoughtful and so it really goes deep, and I love how you're always so sweet. I see your comments on other people's when you're like, may I use this?
Yeah,
it's very sweet.
Because I try to be
respectful and kind, and that's, you know, those are things that I try to be and respect. It's just a nice way to be, you know. Never gonna look back on your life and say, I wish I would have been more of a dick. You can look back at your life and go like, I wish I was nicer. So, very nice and kind, and you're really good too.
Oh my God, thank you.
You're very informative. Oh, I love it. Yeah.